Hey everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to introduce you to the workflow for auto mode for the headshot plugin, from loading an image to editing the shape and textures. Auto mode is a faster and more basic mode that is used for faster character generation, generally for characters that don't need to be as close to the camera, such as NPCs or passive characters in your game. Auto mode only uses 1K images for head generation. Even if you use a larger resolution image, it will have no additional effect because it will be reduced upon head generation. Auto mode will also generate 3D hair, which is a feature that Pro mode doesn't have. It's fully automatic, and we'll take a look at the intelligent texture blend near the end of the video. Okay, to start, let's load up an image. We'll keep the same body type since our on-screen model is female as well. For skin type, we're going to choose clean soft since it's a female character, and then we'll go ahead and process. Once that's finished, let's take a look at the head. You'll notice first of all that our character's entire skin color has changed to match that of the head. You'll also see it generated a 3D hair item which can be found in the scene manager. You can decide to show or hide that depending on your preference. Auto mode will separate the skin and scalp clearly as well, so when we hide the hair we can see the head texture is still clean without any hair. You can choose wireframe unshaded mode to see the geometry of the hair. Also notice that an alpha channel image was generated which can be found in the opacity channel. Let's take a look at the head shape now. Generally, when the head shape is produced in auto mode, it'll be roughly 80 to 90% accurate based on the image. You can further adjust the shape by selecting Activate Sculpt Morph, or you can also use the morph sliders in the Modify panel. Headshot will include a massive amount of detailed custom sliders in the Headshot Morph 1000 Plus pack that you can use. So it's highly recommended if you want enhanced control over your character's face shape. You can also activate or deactivate Sculpt Morph mode from the upper toolbar, or use the Shift S hotkey to toggle it on or off. As with the Pro mode, there are 6 different defined areas that you can adjust. You can access them using the Z, X, C, V, B, and N hotkeys. Notice that when you adjust the control area on the character's face, that the corresponding parameter in the Modify panel will move according to your control. You can adjust all of the different facial features using the control areas just like traditional method with CC3. In more detailed sculpt morphs, you can access further musculature and facial feature details, and the same goes for all of the other areas. The Modify panel to the right will change to show the slider for the feature you're modifying. Sometimes it's hard to see the character's facial features with the control areas over top of it, so we can toggle Show Control Area on or off to get a better look at our character's face. If we take a look at the character's mouth, you'll notice that the sides are a bit uneven. We can modify those separately by clicking on Symmetrical or using the Control A hotkey and dragging one of the control areas to make it more accurate to the picture. We can also do things like adjust the eyes separately as well, using the plethora of sliders that we have in the Headshot 1000 pack. Little things like iris scale and position are very important. Another new feature with Headshot 1000 is under the Headshot item in the Morph tab, you'll find Headshot sliders to enhance perspective, which can be found under the Face item. One more useful new feature is the ability to set the head position. You can adjust it back and forth as well. Keep in mind that this won't affect the bone root or the position, it only affects the morph position. After we finish shape adjustment, let's take a look at texture adjustments. We can choose any one of the 5 eyeball color templates. In this case, she has gray eyes, so let's choose that first. The current skin type, if you recall, is set to clean and soft. If you want to adjust this to something else, we simply need to select it. Let's select old female first. Notice nothing will happen until you select update skin texture. Once it's finished processing, if we zoom in, we can see slightly older face appearance on our character, with a new base and normal map. Let's try the contour preset next. You'll notice the texture maps change once we select it. Once we hit update skin texture, you'll see the results right away. We'll talk a little bit more about the skin color and settings in another video where we'll show you how to really enhance the textures. Okay, so here's the final result once we've done our enhancements. You can see how it looks fairly accurate to the source image, and it can be used at medium distances to the camera quite nicely. Finally, we're going to look at texture blend, and for this we'll use a different character with facial hair. Let's load up a male image with a beard, and we'll keep the same body type and choose no mask for our skin type. Once it's finished generating, we can see that the beard range is clearly defined after it's been automatically calculated and is nicely blending into the hair. If we make the auto-generated hair invisible, we can see the base of that blending. And here is the final result. Auto mode is a great way to quickly and easily generate accurate-looking characters for use in mid-range camera distances. Due to their low resource load, you can use many of them in your project without consuming too much of the system resources. Thanks for watching, everyone, and make sure you check out our other headshot tutorials to learn more about this awesome plugin. See you in the next video.